Al, we're talking a lot about leverage and being more capital efficient. That's what a smart investor strives to do, mm-hmm. right? You don't want to use all your capital, or what they call it, put all your eggs in one basket, right? Sure. Now, these other assets that we talk about, including with options, like futures and Forex, those are great for people that are looking to trade on a shorter term basis, not day trading, more on a shorter term, like daily or weekly investing, right?
Right.
Talk a little bit about what those are. Why? What are some of the perks? What are some of the downfalls, so our listeners can understand, okay, where do I need to be? Each one is customized. Everybody has a different plan. A different plan might be the right asset, understanding that.
Well, there's really kind of two parts to your trading and investing. One is what we're going to call the timing part of it. And the second is the asset, the right assets, the right strategies to use for you and for what your goals are. Everybody may have a little bit of a different path which they want to follow to get to their end result. I mean, what do you want your life to look like in 5 years or 10 years or 20 years? There's a proper way or a best way for you to do that compared to maybe somebody else who might have a different end point in mind. So the timing part of it is really critical. And our core strategy, the OTA core strategy, is a foundational strategy that is a timing mechanism. What do we mean by timing? What is timing the market? Because most of you have heard this statement. It's time in the market, not timing the market, that's important. And what the Wall Street firms will tell you is you have to be in the market. It's time in the market because you don't want to miss the big up days. Well, if that's the case, you have to be in the market because you're going to miss the down days. I mean, you're going to be in the down days too. So mm-hmm. you have to participate in the up days to kind of counter the loss in the down days. Timing the market is this. It's finding a price where that price has the lowest risk potential and the highest odds of working in your favor with a high profit potential. That's really the goal of timing. How can we do that? I mean, there's no crystal ball out there. You can't just look at something and guess how it's going to react in the future. But you can look at something that happens on a reliable and a consistent basis, a repeatable basis, and that's institutional activity. That's buying and selling by the big firms with a large enough amount of money, we're talking millions of dollars, into a position. That's enough to move the price.
Yeah, but that might be at or near that term or that turn in price, right?
Well, that's where the highest quality trades are. And the highest quality trades are going to be the one that gives you the lowest risk entry point, you know, with the odds being in your favor, that is going to work in your favor. And that happens at the turn in price almost always. And that price turn happens when institutions buy or sell. Well, they don't call us and tell us when they're doing that, but they show us. On a price chart, we can read what they're doing. We can read really in advance what they're going to be doing when the price goes into a certain level. If they're buying, we can identify where future buys are going to take place at a certain price. If they're selling, we can identify with a high degree of accuracy where those sell orders will come in the market. And when you think about it, the only thing that really moves the price are buyers and sellers. Then you can have the best company in the world with the best product, but if no one buys their stock, it doesn't go anywhere. You can have the worst company in the world that should not be in business, but if nobody sells their stock, it won't go down in value. It's buyers and sellers that impact the price of something. And price is the most important component of your trade or investment. If you go into a financial advisor with whatever the amount of money is that you have, they're going to say, we need to get that in the market right now because, again, it's time in the market. They disregard the importance or significance of price, but the price that you enter or exit a trade or investment in, that determines the quality of your protection, and it also impacts the profit potential that you have. And those are important components to any trade.
That's funny you said that with when they're saying you need to be in the market right now, that's basically saying, give me my fee for doing something you could probably do on your own.
Right. Well, if they say we need to get you in the market right now, what if you're at the peak of the market? Like, what if went into somebody now, or maybe in end of 2007, if you went into a financial advisor, they would say we need to get you in the market now, just before, maybe months or weeks before the market turned and it just cratered. It was down 57% in about 17 months, and that wiped out 12 years worth of returns in the market. But if you can identify the right price, and sometimes that means waiting, you need to have some patience. But if you can do this in a way where you're putting the odds in your favor of something moving in the direction that you want it to move in, that's what you need to do. Maybe it means waiting, maybe it means getting in now, but it's identifying that price. And that's what our core strategy does. It is designed by people that were in the market that actually functioned as market makers and were responsible for moving the price. So they understand how that works, and they incorporated that into our core strategy.
I'm really glad you brought that up. I mean, advisors and brokers, nothing against them. It's the business, right?
Sure.
But they will say, we got to get you in the market right now. Now think about this concept. If you're listening right now, just think about this. The lowest risk, the highest reward, highest opportunity in the market is actually at or near a turn in price. If we are at all-time highs, where would the next turn go? It would actually be down because it's already going up, right? It's already at all-time highs. Now think about that concept. Does that make sense? That's why you need a strategy for any market condition. An advisor or broker is not going to put you in that strategy. They're going to put you in an up moving market strategy only. That's all they have the ability to do. Self-directing, you have opportunities in up markets, you have opportunities in down markets, but also sideways. But you got to learn the techniques and strategies. It starts with knowledge. Al, coming up next, I want to talk about that where you can read what they are doing is based off a price chart. I'm going to talk about that in the next segment. We will be right back.